We studied the first night of the great image that Nebuchadnezzar dreamed about. We saw that the image head was of gold, the breast and the arms were of silver, the belly and the thighs were of brass, the legs of iron, and the feet part of iron and part of clay. We saw that this image symbolized Gentile world powers from Daniel's time into all eternity, beginning with Nebuchadnezzar, who was plainly told that thou art this head of gold, and after thee shall arise another kingdom inferior to thee, and another third kingdom of brass, which shall bear rule over all the earth, and the fourth kingdom shall be strong as iron. Thus Nebuchadnezzar's kingdom is symbolized by the head of gold. The Medo-Persian Empire is symbolized by the breast and arms of silver. The old Grecian Empire under Alexander the Great, symbolized by the belly and the thighs of brass. And the old Roman Empire, symbolized by the iron on the image. And the two legs represent the two divisions of the old Roman Empire, the eastern and western division. He saw the image with 10 toes, and they were a mixture of potter's clay and iron. They were symbolic of 10 kingdoms that will be formed inside of the Roman Empire in the latter days. Then he saw a stone cut out of the mountain without hands, which smote the image on the feet and brake all these metals in pieces. They became like the chaff before the summer threshing floor, and the wind carried them away. That represented in verses 44 and 45, as explained, the kingdom of the God of heaven. In the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed. It shall not be left to other peoples, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. We saw in chapter 7 a vision of 4 great beasts, diverse one from the other. We read that these 4 beasts are 4 kings that shall arise out of the earth. Thus these 4 beasts, the lion, the bear, the leopard, and the nondescript beast, are symbolic of the same kingdoms as symbolized by the metals in the image of Daniel 2. 4 world empires, the empire of Babylon, Media, Persia, Greece, and Rome. We saw that this 4th beast had 10 horns, and that among those horns came forth another little horn, before whom 3 of the 1st horns were plucked up by the roots. And he saw in that little horn eyes like the eyes of a man, and a mouth that spake very great things, whose look was more stout than his fellow. He saw that little horn coming out of the 10 horns, overthrowing 3 of the 10 horns. Plucking them up by the roots. He saw that little horn making war with the saints and prevailing against them until the Ancient of Days came and judgment was given to the saints of the Most High, and the time came that the saints possessed the kingdom.